from new hotel chains and smaller boutique offerings are starting to respond to what the public want, and that's a heavier focus on architecture and design. Well, joining us now to talk about this trend is interior designer, writer and founder of Design Travel, Stephanie Williams. Stephanie, thank you so much for joining us. Now, just talk us through why design matters in a hotel.
Well, anybody can walk into a hotel room and see the lovely bedspreads and the pretty cushions, but what actually matters is the behind-the-scenes decisions that designers make as to where the PowerPoints are placed, where the lights are, and all these little micro-decisions that come together to make a room really special.
Yeah, and I imagine there's a lot of time and effort that goes into all of those considerations.
Absolutely, absolutely. There's a lot of time spent on making sure that that user experience is really strong from the time that you check in, from the time that you check out. Every little thing is really thought of in these beautiful boutique hotels.
Do travellers tend to choose those hotels because of their design? They might be willing to, say, forego other elements of a hotel, but sort of choosing it specifically because of the design aspect?
Some people are starting to do that. It's a really emerging part of the industry. It's a really strong part of the industry, and it's growing, particularly in the millennial space.
Now, where's the latest design hotel you stayed at? Just talk us through, ones that, you know, your own experience.
Well, last week I had the great pleasure of staying at one of Australia's first storytelling hotels. MAP01, which is on the waterfront in Hobart, opened a few weeks ago, and it is absolutely spectacular. From the moment you walk through the door, you're asked to turn all of the ideas that you have about what Tasmania is on its side, and there's even a beautiful graphic on the sliding doors as they slide apart to show you Tassie on its side, kind of throwing everything out the window. It's Australia's first storytelling hotel, as I mentioned. And they have four storytellers full-time who will show you around the hotel and bring the stories of special Tasmanians to life. So each of the rooms, there are 114 rooms, each of the rooms is dedicated to one special Tasmanian, whether it be Ma O'Dwyer, who was a brothel madam from the 1800s, or to Alec Campbell, who is the last surviving Anzac. The stories are phenomenal. They've been unearthed from some incredible journeys around Tassie, and they've really brought it to life in the design. So the bedheads are designed by an incredible artist called Troy Ruffles from Devonport on the northwest coast, right through to the light fittings, which are handmade by a legally blind artist called Duncan Merding, and you can actually see a little video of him producing those lights on my website, designtravel.com.au. And then right through to the user experience again. So everything's been thought of.
Yeah, it sounds incredible. So MAP01 there in Hobart. What about some of the other design hotspots in Australia right now?
Canberra's been experiencing a really big boom in design hotels. We had Hotel open a few years ago, which went on to win a lot of international design awards, particularly for its incredible foyer art by March Studios, a Melbourne firm. Then there's Hotel Currajong, which is actually my favourite hotel whenever I get to go to Canberra. It used to be the residence for politicians who just would wander up the hill, which is very close by, to Parliament House. But now it's been refurbished by SJB Architects, and it's a really beautiful, restful, homely space, but with that Art Deco edge that everyone seems to love.
All right, fantastic. Perth, lots of openings as well, so sort of, these design hotels popping up all over the country.
Yeah, there's been a really big boom at the moment in Perth with the opening in the last few weeks of Aloft and Tribe. And there's also quite a bit going on again in Hobart with 1,200 rooms coming online between now and 2018, the opening of Crown Plaza and Marriott in 2018, and also in the next few weeks, Ibis Styles is coming, and then Vibe a little after that.
Now, Stephanie, it's not just the boutique hotels. Some of the larger hotel chains as well seem to be getting in on the action.
They are. So you've probably heard of QT Hotels or Overlo Hotels. They're really doing a great job of blending that leisure and business travel experience. So they kind of know that people are coming to Sydney and Melbourne and Brisbane and places like that for work, but they want to give them an experience outside of work. So, you know, down at QT Bondi, for instance, you can have a surf before work or borrow one of their bikes and take a ride around the neighbourhood and then go have your business meetings and come back and really get to enjoy that neighbourhood again. For dinner, drinks at night time. So they're really kind of working out how to share the local neighbourhoods with you.
And if we look at sort of some of the overseas examples, particularly say for those business travellers, Ace Hotel seems to be blending a lot of art along with business.
They are, yeah. They're definitely focusing on that younger millennial market. And they really try to naturally promote a freelancer vibe in their lobbies, which kind of has a flow-on effect for that particular market into building confidence as to, you know, what they're going to experience when they're in the hotel. So they make it very easy for you to have cocktails, to get your laptop out, to have a meeting, just to really kind of feel like you're part of the vibe that's going on. And the Ace Portland Hotel is a particularly good example of this. And it's one that we featured on our Instagram feed this week. And, yeah, everyone is really loving that hotel.
All right, fantastic. Now, you mentioned a couple of those features there, not only on your Instagram feed, but on your website, Design Travel. Talk us through what else you've got on the horizon.
Yeah, so we're actually starting a series of podcasts, which is about to be released. We're working on that at the moment. We've got a few of the big players like Qantas involved, which is really exciting. And then we're also going to be looking at developing some really strong design destination guides, starting with Hobart and Melbourne, and really delving into what it takes to make a great design holiday. So it's not just about the hotel. It's about where you eat, where you stay, where you play, all of those kind of things. So we're really looking to kind of turn those type of guides on their head and produce something really interesting.
All right, Stephanie, it's been wonderful talking to you. We appreciate you joining us. Thank you so much. Well, that's all we have time for on Business Class this week from the team here. Thanks for your company.